In this video, I will just explain a few Discman bugs, because recently I released a video in which I showed how to generate a pig spawner in 1.8, and in that video I used a certain bug which is not explained anywhere before, so I will explain that Discman bug that makes it possible in this video, and also talk a little bit about the general setup I used to generate the pig spawner. But first, a little bit of piston behavior. If this piston wants to move these blocks, and this piston behavior is 1.8 piston behavior, I will mainly focus on 1.8 piston behavior in this video. But anyway, when this piston wants to move these blocks, the first thing he will do is he will create a list of the positions of the blocks he wants to move, and a list of the blocks he wants to destroy. So, for example, he would denote this position in the list, and this, all of this which he would get into a list of positions of blocks he wants to move, and the 2 millions would get into a list of blocks which should get destroyed. After that, the piston will destroy all the blocks that he wants to destroy. And after he has destroyed the blocks, he will move the blocks, and at the end he will generate his piston head and so on. And this thing does is just block 36 down here. Now, a bug can occur if you replace one of the blocks after the piston has already made his list. So, for example, if this piston has already made his list and then I replace this one by an iron block, then this piston would destroy an iron block, even though he normally can't destroy iron blocks. Or if I would replace one of the iron blocks by a melon, then he would move the melon because he has denoted this position in the list, and then he would move the block. So, I think I will just show some examples where this occurs. So the first example is right here, and right here the piston will destroy an obsidian block and drop the obsidian as an item. And this works in 1.8 until the recent versions, this particular bug. So if I power this piston, then we will get an obsidian block right here. And now I will explain how it works. So we start with this thing. Then the piston wants to extend, so he makes a list of blocks that he wants to move. That will be the 3 slime blocks. And he will make a list of blocks that he wants to destroy. He wants to destroy the torch and the lava block. Then the piston will destroy the first block. The first block that he will destroy will be the torch. Because with the slime block update order, it's usually the case that blocks which are further away from the piston get purposed first, and this torch is further away than the lava, so this torch gets destroyed first. When the torch gets destroyed, it will update the lava. The lava will see that it's next to water, and then the lava will turn into obsidian. So that's the first block that got destroyed, and after that the piston will destroy the second block. Now the second block is now an obsidian block, so the piston will just destroy the obsidian and drop it as an item. That's how this works. And now I don't know any survival-friendly way to get survival. But you can get a non-source lava block next to water and survival, and with this you can make a cobblestone farm if you want. So right here we have a cobblestone farm that uses that, and which automatically produces cobblestone. If you're interested, I will just leave a world download. And this works from 1.8 to 1.11.0, and it was fixed in 1.11.2. But this just generates cobblestone, and it uses exactly this bug to destroy the cobblestone, and it's kind of slow, but it works. So that's one application of this bug. Now, right here we replaced a block which the piston wanted to destroy by a different block. Now another thing that you can do is you can replace one of the blocks that the piston wants to move by a different block. So for example, if we were to replace one of these iron blocks by an obsidian, then the piston would move the obsidian. Now it's very hard to find an example for that. All examples are kind of either completely useless or very advanced, so I will just show you a completely useless example. Namely in 1.8 and 1.8 only, you can move air blocks. So right here, if I extend this piston, then the rail will get destroyed, but before that it will get into a list of blocks which you want to move, and then you will get a block 36 of air. And you can see that by the fact that if I power this piston, then you can instantly see an item. I don't know whether you can see it well, but under the statistics button, you can see a rail item, so the rail already popped off. And if you can see the rail down below, then that's just a little glitch. but even though the rail isn't there anymore, it will still update the piston. And you might wonder, why does this piston get an update if there's nothing landing the same? And the reason is that there's a block 36 of air right there, which you just can't see because air is invisible and stuff. But the piston gets updated even though there's it's updated by a block 36 of air. So that's one example that's kind of useless, but it's interesting, so it works like this. This piston wants to extend, so he makes a list of all the blocks which he wants to move, so he will denote these four positions. Then he will move the first block. When he does that, the rail will pop off, because there's no block underneath the rail. Then he will move the second block. And then he will move the third block, and now the third block will be air, because the rail is already gone, and then we will get a block 36 of air, and that's how this works. That's pretty useless, but that's kind of the simplest example how you can move an unmovable block, because this basically allows you to move air. Now, in the video in which I generated the pig spawner, I used this glitch to move a spawner, and it basically went like this. We had a piston. This piston wants to extend, so he makes a list of blocks which he wants to move. And then we will use additional tricks, which I'll talk about in a moment, to then generate a spawner in this position, in the position of the gold block. And then we will have a spawner and all the other blocks will get replaced because we will have generated a dungeon in the place. Even the piston will disappear, but that doesn't prevent the piston from moving the blocks, so the piston will have disappeared, but he will still be able to move the block. That's kind of weird, but it works. So, and then the piston will just move all these blocks, so we will get 3 blocks at 6 as air, and we will also move the spawner. And after that, the piston will generate the headless piston base at the piston head, and then we will get a piston and we will get a spawner after 2 game ticks. Yeah. And the spawner will lose its tile entity because it got moved, but the tile entity didn't get moved along, so we get a tile entity less spawner, and that's a pig spawner. So that's how you generate a pig spawner. You just need to move the spawner. The piston needs to denote the position of the spawner in a list of blocks you want to move before the spawner gets generated. Then you generate the spawner and then you move them over. Now, to generate the spawner, you use Terran population. I will link a video by Panda down in the description to discover the initial methods to generate spawners. And if you don't know that video, then you should really check it out. But basically the idea is, if a chunk gets generated newly in the world, then it does not instantly generate dungeons, and some other stuff also doesn't get generated. But dungeons only get generated if the chunk is generated and the chunk in the positive x and z direction are also generated. And in the flying machine, which I have shown in my previous video, what I do is I have a piston right here, and I have blocks like this, and when this piston starts to move, then he will, I think I will just go through this, and he will make a list of blocks that he wants to move. And then he will start with the diamond block, so the diamond block will get moved first, so he will move the diamond block. And when he moves the diamond block, then the diamond block will send out block updates to the surrounding chunks. And then one block update will get into this chunk, then this chunk will get loaded. Then these four chunks are all loaded, and then this chunk will get populated. And when this chunk gets populated, then we'll get a spawner. I will just use an obsidian block. And then all these other blocks still get moved, and then the spawner gets moved. And that's basically how it works in the video. And that's actually about everything which I wanted to show. Something I should mention is that it's not that easy to get the diamond block into the correct position here, because you need to get the diamond block into here without populating this chunk. But if you place the diamond block here, then this chunk will get loaded for sure, this chunk will get loaded for sure, and this chunk also. So you need to place the diamond block in a way that this chunk isn't loaded when this diamond block gets placed here. So you can't just push it in like this. But if you push it in like this, then this chunk would be loaded, but you have to come from the side so that you take the diamond block from here, and then you push it over there, and then you can push it over here, and then this chunk doesn't get loaded. Then you need to wait for the autosave, so that these two chunks get unloaded, and then you can come with the other blocks and perform the glitch. And that's basically everything. That's just the setup I used in the with this video to push your diamond block over, but that's not that important. So you can see it just pushes the diamond block over. But that's actually everything I wanted to show in this video.